Wow, your room is so much bigger than mine. Well, bigger than I imagine mine would be if I had one.
I'm guessing you usually knock before coming into a person's room?
Nah, don't see much point. Are you all right, ma'am? You seem upset.
No, I'm not all right, as a matter of fact. Somebody stole my pearls last night from right out of this very room. And whoever it was left this strange orb in its place. I'm in a state of shock.
Pearls, huh? Patrick, what do you think?
I think it's a job for Detective SpongeBob and Inspector Star.
Me too. Never fear, madam. We have never lost a case or even taken on a case. In either case, we have a perfect record. To be brief, case.
Oh, dear.
We will investigate this matter fully. Search every nook and cranny for clues, just in case. Be all over this place like a cheap suit. Case.
I don't know what to say.
Inspector Star, we must keep our eyes peeled. Give everything a long, hard look. If people think we're rude, so be it. If staring will solve this crime, then we shall stare. Case.
Staircase.
Nice talking to you.
Yes, a pleasant, mindless break for me as well.
Those are strange holes. They look like wood rot, but it's too dark to see down them. If only I had more light. Yes, Patrick?
I think I'm gonna stay out here.
Why?
I'm afraid of caves.
But you live under a rock.
And?
Well, I mean, a cave, a rock.
Are you saying my house is like a cave?
Oh, not really. Slightly cave-ish, maybe.
I'm gonna pretend like I didn't hear that.
Okay, have it your way. Wait here, I won't be long. Are you lost?
Hardly. One cannot be lost when one is at home. I am Charles Oscar William Piedmont Augustus Winthorpe, and the world is my backyard. From the Marianas Trench to the Great Barrier Reef, wherever I go, home follows.
Are you a superhero?
No, I am an explorer.
Pretty long introduction for someone who's not a superhero. Possibly lend me your flashlight?
Well, I suppose you can borrow it. Now don't break it. It is precious.
Gimme!
Use it well.
Good luck with your expedition. I've gotta go.
Yes, off with you.
Thought that guy said there'd be lights in here.
Welcome to the confounding corridors of crustacean caverns. Follow the lights, or you will surely be lost.
Whoa! Easy on the reverb there, Ringo.
Enter each corridor in the order it lights up. A mistake will lead you back to the beginning! Only through concentration can you hope to make it to the inner sanctum of the crustacean caverns.
Okay. Guess I'd better pay attention. old, aren't you?
Indeed I am. What I lack in youthful vigor, I make up for in tact.
I'm not sure what tact is, but I'm pretty sure I've got more of it than some old fogey.
Who can argue with that logic?
Say, you wouldn't by any chance know a way to cross the abyssal plains, would you?
Actually, I do. The inner sanctum lies beyond the doors here. In it is a device that uses sunlight to illuminate a path through the fog of the abyssal plains.
Great! I am so there!
I cannot let you in. The focusing orb has been stolen. Those doors must remain locked until the orb has returned.
Focusing orb?
Yes, it aims and intensifies the light. The inner sanctum does not function without it. It would be of no use to you.
Who stole it?
I don't know. Nobody can get to the inner sanctum without passing by me, and nobody did. But if you can find it, I will allow you passage beyond these doors.
Well, nice talking to you.
Personally, the conversation has renewed my interest in taking a vow of silence.
Those look comfortable, but this is no time to sit down. Ah, that's better. Say, it looks like there's another room under here. I wonder how I can get there. Maybe the manager knows. Hello there! Nice place you got here!
It is indeed. Oh, indeed it is.
Sort of an odd place for such a swank hotel.
What can I tell you? Speculative real estate is a risky business. And I got this place for a song. The land was an old oyster bed. Nobody would touch it.
Well, nice talking to you.
Your suavity, your elegant way with words, I shan't soon forget you.
Smells like feet.
Yeah, it does. It's horrible.
Oh, I kind of like it.
If the fog gets any thicker, it's going to be tough to see where we're going. It's too foggy to see. I could get eaten by a Gru. Hello again, Patrick.
Hey, SpongeBob.
What about a heated pool? That'd be nice, huh?
Oh, yeah, anything you say, SpongeBob.
Oh, forget it. It's too foggy to see. I could get eaten by a Gru. Hi!
Huh? Oh, hi.
This fog is pretty bad, huh?
Yeah. You need a lighthouse to cross this place without getting hopelessly lost.
I'm gonna go.
Sure. Whatever.
Oh, the sheer luck with which I've been graced. Someone fanned me, I may faint.
Do you know one of your tenants had some pearls stolen from her?
Yes, Victoria Ellen in room 1. How could I not know? She has made quite a stink about it.
Well, well, well. We have come to a conclusion from our investigation.
Pray tell, I'm all ears. Can't wait to hear it.
There is something living under the hotel that comes in through holes in the floors of your rooms. I think this creature may have taken Mrs. Ellen's pearls.
No, it can't be. I knew something like this might happen.
Something like what?
Well, when I bought the land for this hotel, there was an old oyster bed here. I didn't think it would make a difference, but maybe, just maybe.
Oysters, huh? May I have permission to check under the hotel?
Oh yes, this is all my fault. Check! Check!
Well, nice talking to you.
Your suavity, your elegant way with words, I shan't soon forget you.
It's an oyster bed. Wow, this little guy sure has collected a lot of stuff. Those holes must lead to the hotel rooms. They really should get them corked. Look like Mrs. Ellen's string of pearls. The little guy must have thought they were his. I'd better return them to her. Those look comfortable, but this is no time to sit down. Hello again, elderly person.
Hello again, slightly annoying and yet oddly endearing person.
Here are your your pearls, Mrs. Ellen.
Oh, thank you so very much, young man. These were a gift from my darling first husband, Edward. They mean so much to me.
Ask her about the reward. Ask her about the reward.
Patrick, that isn't very polite.
Oh, sorry. Please ask her about the reward. Please ask her about the reward.
Well, you boys certainly deserve a reward. Here, take this orb. I don't need it now that I have my pearls back.
Hooray! A reward! I don't think so. I don't think so. Stay here. I'll be out in a minute.
Okay.
Hello again, elderly person.
That's a little more respectful.
Look, I got the focusing orb! Go me! Go me!
Ah, excellent! I will open the doors for you. Beyond them, you will face another puzzle before getting to the Inner Sanctum. Once you have passed it, place the orb on the pedestal. Then the fog will lift.
Great! Thank you, O Ancient One.
I'm 52.
Wow! And I thought only Coral lived that long. This looks familiar.
Welcome to the Confounding Corridors of Crustacean Caverns, Part 2, The Revenge.
Part 1 was way better.
Follow the lights, or you will surely be lost.
Here we go again. Taking the wrong corridor. The pink door was the right one. It's a bullseye. There's a hole in the center. Looks like it goes outside somewhere.
I don't think so. It's some kind of crazy pedestal thing. There's a place for something round on top, but there's nothing in it. Wow, it's like magic, without the rabbit. Ooh, the light cuts through the fog. We should follow it.
Having conquered the trench, SpongeBob and Patrick have a swagger in their step, knowing that the worst is behind them. Unfortunately, they do not realize how true that is, for an assassin is stealthily tracking them. Hired by Plankton to stop their meddling, he has been gaining ground on them steadily.
I'll get you.